So good morning. Today we're going to discuss about algebra and general mathematics. Pakilala muna ako, I'm Sir Jaisel, Engineer Jaisel De Lara. So going to discuss about algebra and general mathematics. So for our first topic today, we have set theory, numbers, and then absolute value and so on. Share ko muna kung bakit gusto kong mag-share ng knowledge or gusto kong magturo ng different subjects. So basically, after ko mag-take ng board, nakakaroon din ako ng experience sa teaching. So nagturo ako sa review center sa Maynila. So nakapagturo ako dun sa dalawang review center, and then I also conducted review sessions with different universities in Cavite, in Laguna, and in Batangas. So most nung mga subjects na tinuro ko is ECE subjects. So mathematics, algebra, statistics, differential calculus, and integral calculus. Then advanced mathematics, differential equations, trigonometry. So ayun, nakapagturo din ako. And then ngayon, gusto ko mag-share kasi ngayon, mas kailangan yung online learning kasi nga, di ba, naka-online class yung education system natin ngayong pandemic. So, naisipan ko mag-share ng knowledge since capable naman ako, and then ito rin makatulong doon sa mga estudyante and then sa mga magulang na nahihirapan magturo. So, ayun, I decided to start with the starting subject, which is algebra, and all throughout hanggang dun sa ano, sa latter part ng mathematics. So try natin niyang discuss lahat. So hindi man topic by topic, at least overview dun sa mga subjects. So dito sa algebra, itatry ko siyang i-discuss as much as possible yung detailed sa mga topics. So ayun, start na tayo. So for our discussion today, we're going to discuss about set theory. So basically, when we say set, it is a defined collection of symbols of or object, and then those symbols or object that comprise the set is called element or elements. Those are called elements or members. So when we say set, ulat lang natin para masundan. So set is a defined collection of symbols and objects. Set is a defined collection of symbols or set, or collection of symbols or object. And then itong symbols na to, symbols or object, are called elements or members. Ayan. Set, ulitin natin, set is a defined collection of symbols or objects. And yung tawag natin doon sa mga symbols na to, or yung data or information, ay elements or members. So basically, we have two types of set, or two classification of set, which is, first we have tabular. First we have tabular. We have tabular and set builder. So, ano nga ba yung pinakaiba nitong dalawang ito? So, basically, yung tabular, ito yung set kung saan yung elements ay nakalagay lahat dun sa loob ng braces. So, for example, we have if a set A is a set of natural number less than 10, or when we say if a set A is a set of counting numbers. So, counting numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so on. So, you can write it in a tabular form. So ayan, in a tabular form set, we have the all distinct elements written inside the braces. So ayan, and then when we say naman set builder, ito naman yung type ng set kung saan naka-written siya in word format or stated like a mathematical sentence. So ayan, doon naman sa set builder, yung properties ng ating elements sa loob ng braces, naka-written siya in a mathematical sentence or stated in a mathematical statement. So, for example, if a set A is a set of natural numbers less than 10. So, pag sinulat natin siya in set form, A is a set of X such that, so kung paano basahin yung ito, itong pipe, so such that X is a natural number less than 10. So ayun, so nakita natin yung pagkakaiba ng dalawa. Tabular form, lahat ng elements is written inside the braces. And then the set builder, ito naman yung elements mo is hindi mo makikita inside the braces, but yung properties kung ano yung elements na yon, dun siya naka-state sa loob ng brace in mathematical sentence. So X is a natural number less than 10. So wala kang makikitang elements separated by comma, unlike sa tabular. So yun yung main difference nila. Then next, we have different kinds of set naman na tinatawag. So basically, I have here the first five. So we have finite set, singleton, null, and subset. So when we say finite set, it is a set with a finite number of elements inside the braces. So ito ay so ayun yung finite, it has finite number of elements inside the braces. And then when we say infinite, so ito naman yung kabaligtaran niya, infinite number of elements inside the braces. And then we have singleton, ito naman yun kapag meron lang siyang isang element sa loob ng braces. Then kapag null naman, ito yung empty yung ating braces, so walang laman, so empty set. or void. Empty set or void na tinatawag. Then for subset, ito naman yung kapag yung isang set is part of another set. For example, set A is yung elements niya is makikita mo rin dun sa set B. So, yun yung tinatawag na subset. When a set is part of another set. A set is part of another set. So, example nito is example ng finite number of elements. Ito yung kapag meron tayong mga delimitation dun sa set. Delimitation meaning kumbaga may hangganan yung hinahanap na number of elements or we have distinct number of elements. For example, X is a natural number less than 5. So, in a tabular form, we can write it as five. So, dito, yung set daw natin is a natural number less than 5. Less than, sabihin na natin less than or equal to 5. So, basically, lalagay natin siya 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, meron tayong delimitation na number of elements which is equal or less than 5 daw. So, basically, hanggang 5 lang yung maisulat natin na elements or element. And then, for infinite set, ang example naman nito is X is a counting number. So, basically, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hanggang kung saan man yung ika-count mo. So, basically, wala kang specific number of elements na isusulat dun sa loob ng braces natin. So, pag isusulat natin siya, A equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, ito. Pag susulat natin siya is, set A is 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Kasi counting numbers, infinite yun. Wala tayong distinct number of elements. And then, singleton naman, so, we have only one element inside the set. So, yun. Ang element lang natin is X. Then, for null, basically, for null, yung set natin is void. So, wala. As in, wala. Void yung kanyang set. Then, for subset, a set is a part of another set. And then, yun yung subset naman, sinusulat siya as, for example, yung A. Yan. Let's say we have set A, and then part siya nung set B. So, sulat natin siya as set A is a subset of B. So, yung elements na nandito sa B, sa A is makikita natin sa elements na nakay B. So, yun yung subset. Then, we have another we have another four types of four kinds of set. Ito yung universal set, equal set, equivalent. Bali tatlo na lang pala. So meron tayong universal set, equal set, and equivalent set. So aburan ko lang to. For our number 6, we have so basically we have universal set, equal set, and equivalent set. So when we say universal, ito yung for example, meron kang set A, set B, and then yung universal set is composed of all elements na makikita mo dun sa A and B. So para siyang collection ng lahat ng data elements dun sa mga given set. So for example, we have set A, set B, 1. So for example, ito. Yung set A natin is composed of elements 1, 2, 3. And then set B composed of elements 4, 5, 6, 7. So yung universal set is para siyang combination ng dalawa. So makikita natin na then meron din tayo set C. So basically we have 3 different sets. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 for set B. Then dun sa set C, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So dito sa tatlong to, yung universal set na tinatawag is yung set C. Kasi yung set A and set B is nandito sa set C. And then, ayun, mapapansin nyo din is yung set A at set B, subset siya nitong set C. Kaya, makaklassify natin as universal set itong set C. So, nuggets ba? So, when we say equal set, ito naman yung kapag yung dalawang set, bawa A and B, set A, we have set A, 3, 5, 7, 9. For example, we have set A, 3, 5, 7, 9, then we have set B, which is 3, 5, 7, 9. So masasabi nating equal set siya kapag yung set A is a subset of set B and B is a subset of A. So ayan, masasabi natin siyang equal set kapag ito yung kanyang property na makikita. Yung set A daw is subset of B and B is a subset of A. So ayun. And then when we say equivalent naman, ito naman yung kapag mayroon kang similar or equal number of distinct elements inside the braces. Kahit pa yan ay numbers or objects or symbols, kahit anong elements yun, basta same yung number ng kanilang same yung number ng elements nila dun sa loob ng braces. So yun yung equivalent set. For example, set A, so dito sa example natin, yung set A, we have elements A, B, C, D. So we have 4 elements. And then for set B, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Ito naman number, ito letter. So dito, meron tayong 4 na distinct number of elements. Then dun sa A, meron din tayong 4. So yung equivalent set is naka-base dun sa number of elements inside the braces. So we have equal number of elements, which is 4. So ito is equivalent set. So ayun, bali na-discuss natin yung types of set. We have, recall lang natin, we have finite set. Ito yung may finite number of elements inside the braces. And then we have infinite. Ito yung infinite number of elements naman, yung dire-diretso lang. And then we have ano nga yung pangatlo, singleton. Ito naman yung may single element lang doon sa loob ng brace. And then the fourth one is the null set. Ito yung void, empty set, yung walang laman yung brace. And then five is the subset, when a set is part of another set. Then we have universal set, equal set, and then last is the equivalent set. Additional info lang dito sa equivalent set, yung tawag dun sa distinct number of elements. So dito we have 4. Meron tayong 4 number, 4 distinct elements dun sa loob ng set. So ang tawag dito is cardinal number of set. And then sinusulat siya as So ayun, I hope may natutunan kayo sa different types of set. And then proceed naman tayo dun sa next topic, which is yung set operations. So proceed tayo dun sa mga operations naman. But this time, gawin natin siya in graphical representation, which is yung Venn diagram. So marami naman sigurong pamilyar na kay Venn diagram. So ito yung ginagamit kalimitan kapag mayroon tayong mga problems related dun sa may mga set. And then may mga operations na ginagawa, like dun sa universal, intersection, difference, yung mga ganun. So basically we have 4 distinct operations or set operations. We have first two operations, we have union and intersection. And then we have so nga pala, yung si Venn diagram is I think invented siya by John Venn. Kung di nyo pa alam kung sino yung naka-invento nito, is siya si John Venn. So yan, Venn diagram is invented by John Ben. So, punta tayo sa first operation, yung union. So, when we say union, yung graphical representation niya is yun yung kapag yung set A and set B is pinagsama mo. So, magmi-mix na yung kanyang elements. A and B. Set A and B. Yung intersection naman is etong part na to. Yung kung ano yung meron silang similar dun sa dalawang set. So, sa graphical representation, meron, pangit ang drawing ko ah. So, ayun. Sa intersection naman, ito yung kanyang point of intersection. Kung saan nag-meet yung dalawang set. Kumbaga, siya yung similar element dun sa dalawang set. So, yun yung intersection. Sa complement naman, when we say complement naman, ito yung set kung saan hindi siya part ng set A. So, ito, complement of A is, ito yung set kung saan part ng universal set, pero hindi siya part ng set A. Yung elements na makikita mo dito is, hindi mo makikita dito sa complement ng A. Pero makikita mo siya dun sa universal. Ito. So, parang universal set, tanggalin mo lang yung A. Parang ganun. And then, yung sa difference naman, ito naman yung ito naman sa difference, A minus B. Bali, pag pinag-minus mo yung dalawang set, hindi mo na isasama yung common sa kanilang dalawa. Kumbaga, ito lang yung kukuhanin mo. Ito lang yung kukuhanin mo sa A minus B. Yan. Itong part na to lang yung kukuhanin. Yung set B is hindi mo na siya isasama. Kahit yung intersection, hindi mo na siya isasama. So, ayun, ito, pag sinusulat to is A union B. And then, dito naman is A intersection B. So, ito, A complement. Yan, ganun lang, A complement. So, and then, ito naman, A minus B. So, ayun, yun yung different set operations. So, ibigay tayo ng isang example dito sa Venn diagram para makita natin yung kung paano siya ginagamit. Burahin lang natin. So yan, proceed tayo sa example. So we have a club of 40 executives. Meron na tayo 40 executives and 33 out of 40 like to play golf and 20 like to play bowling. How many like both? So hanapin natin kung gaano karami out of 40 yung may gusto ng parehong laro. So using Venn diagram, so ilet natin yung kabilang circle as kung sino lang may gusto ng golf. Then itong side naman na to is sa bowling. Then yung may gusto nung parehong laro, ilet natin siya as X. Ito yung kanyang nasa intersection. Kasi pareho niyang gusto yung golf, gusto rin niya yung bowling. So ilet lang natin siya as X. Then itong number naman na may gusto lang ng golf, so sabi 33 daw yung may gusto ng golf, pero including doon yung may gusto rin ng bowling at the same time. So para makuha natin to, 33 minus X same as with the bowling, 20 daw yung may gusto ng bowling, pero kasama din doon yung may gusto nung golf at the same time. So kailangan pa natin siyang minus. So we have 20 minus X. Then yung summation nitong tatlo na to equals siya sa 40. So i-add lang natin, then equals to 40 para makuha natin yung value of X. So 33 minus X plus X plus 20 minus X equals to 40. So perform lang natin yung mga operation niya. So we have 33 plus 20 is 53. Then transpose lang natin doon sa kabila. So positive 53, transpose natin sa kabila, magiging negative. So minus 53. Then negative X plus X equals 0 plus negative X equals negative X. So we have negative X equals negative X equals negative 13. So we have to eliminate the negative sign, so multiply lang natin siya sa negative 1 yung both sides. So multiplying both sides of equation into negative 1, you will get the value of X as 13. So ito yung number of executives kung saan gusto nila pareho yung golf and bowling. Then para naman makuha natin yung number of executives na may gusto lang ng golf, 33 minus 13 is 20. So 20 lang yung may gusto ng golf lang mismo. And then 20 minus 13, so 7 lang yung may gusto ng bowling. And then 13 yung may gusto ng pareho. So ayun, sana naintindihan nyo kung paano yung discussion ng Venn diagram. So madali lang naman siya intindihin, practice lang. And then ayun, and then perform lang natin yung mga necessary operations to find the value of X. So proceed naman tayo dun sa next topic, which is yung numbers. So marami kasing type of numbers na may encounter dito sa subject na to. So start natin sa complex number. So we have complex number. When we say complex number, it is a expression involving real number and imaginary number. So, yung form ng complex number natin daw is an expression composing of a real number and an imaginary. So, ganito yung expression niya. A plus BI. So, yung I expression, meaning imaginary siya. So, when we say imaginary number, it is a number that is square root of negative number. So, ito yung example ng imaginary number natin. Square root daw siya ng negative number. So, square root of negative 3 is 3i. So, imaginary. So, ito siya, imaginary number and a real number. So, yung real number, i-discuss natin later kasi marami siyang subcategory. So, ito yung ating complex number. So, kapag yung a daw ay when A is equals to 0, so A equals to 0, ang tawag daw dito is your imaginary. When A equals to 0, it is called pure imaginary. Imaginary number lang yung matitira. And then, when A when B is equals to 0, so real number naman siya. So 0 yung B, so cancel out to. A lang yung matitira, which is real number. So discuss natin yung real number kasi marami siyang subtopic. When we say real number, it is a numbers that are rational and irrational numbers taken together. So, yung rational and irrational, i-discuss din natin one by one. So, real number daw is a number that is rational and irrational taken together. So, when we say rational, these are the numbers that can be written in a so, when we say rational number, ito daw yung number na pwedeng ma-written as a form of M over N. And then, yung irrational naman, yung mga number na hindi pwedeng ma-written dito sa form na to. So, rational number can be written in the form M over N. So, example is example nito ay 250 ano pa ba? 250 negative 4 2 over 3 etc. Yan, basta any number na pwede siyang ma-form dito sa ganitong form. So, ito, ano to? Pwede to 2 over 1, 5 over 1, 0 over 2, so 0. Yan. And then, yung irrational naman, When we say irrational naman, ito naman yung mga numbers na hindi pwedeng ma-written dito. Example niya is square root of 2. So, ito yung example ng mga irrational numbers. Square root of 2, pi, square root of 3, fourth root of 2. So, hindi natin siya mariwritten sa fractional form. Kaya, belong siya dun sa tinatawag na irrational number. So, proceed tayo sa next type of number, which is the integers. When we say integers, these numbers are natural numbers along with their negatives and zero. So any numbers daw or any natural numbers. So example is negative 1, 2, 3, 0, 5, 6. So integers, natural numbers with their negative. So negative 1, negative 3, 0, 5, 6, and so on. So, when we say natural numbers, these are numbers that are formed by the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 0. So, any numbers na mapoform mo gamit yung mga digits na yun, yun yung natural numbers. Except lang dun sa 0 kasi hindi siya considered as natural number, but it is considered as a whole number. So example nito is 1, 2, 3, 10, 11, 9. So ito yung mga example naman ng natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 10, 11, 12, 99, 101. And so on. And natural numbers are also known as positive integers. So basically more on positive lang siya. Then yung integers, dun papasok yung kanyang negative na ganito. Then proceed naman tayo dun sa even numbers. So basically ito yung mga numbers divisible by 2. Example is 2. So, ayan, even numbers. So, any numbers divisible by 2. Then, odd numbers, ito naman yung not exactly divisible by number 2. So, example is 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, and so on. So, basta hindi divisible ng 2, add number siya. Then, next naman is yung prime numbers. So, when we say prime numbers, ito naman yung mga numbers na divisible by 1 or by the number itself. So, example is, example nito. 1, 3, 5, 7. So, yun yung example naman niya. Any numbers that divisible by 1 or by the number itself. So, 1, 3, 5, 7, and so on. Last one is the composite numbers. So, when we say composite naman, ito naman yung mga numbers na maraming factor. Hindi lang siya divisible by 1 or hindi lang siya divisible by the number itself. So, example is we have 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. So itong mga number na to, hindi lang siya divisible by 1 at hindi lang siya divisible by the number itself. So marami siyang factor. Like sa 4, pwede siya sa 2, sa 1, sa 4. So hindi siya limited dun sa 1 at saka dun sa number itself. So yun yung difference ng mga numbers. So proceed naman tayo sa next topic, which is yung absolute value. When we say absolute value, ito, absolute value is the real number of its magnitude or the value without any reference to its sign. So basically, pag absolute value, naririnig natin, papasok agad sa isip natin is positive. Wala siyang sign, negative, kalimitan, naalis lang yung sign na negative. So we have properties of absolute value. We have absolute value of A is greater than or equal to 0. So, hindi siya pwedeng maging negative. Kasi nga, kung negative siya, pag ginawa mo siyang absolute value, mawawala lang yung kanyang negative sign. So, always greater than 0 siya or equal to 0. Then, next property is, so ito yun nga, negative A, absolute value of negative A is equals to absolute value of A. So, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina na kalimitan, nawawala lang yung negative. And then, property number 3, we have the distributive. So, absolute value of A times B, AB, pwede mo siyang paghiwalayin. Absolute value of A times absolute value of B. So, pinaghiwalay mo lang yung kanyang absolute value. And then, number 4, similar lang sa number 3, kaso lang by division naman siya. So, paghiwalayin lang din natin yung kanyang absolute value. Absolute value of A over absolute value of B. So, basically, ito yung property ng, properties ng absolute value natin.